Common installation mistakes. When planning a balanced attic ventilation system, it's important to understand and avoid these common installation mistakes that may reduce the effectiveness of the system. 1. Placing intake too high or exhaust too low. The objective of a balanced attic ventilation system is to bring in fresh air at the lowest part of the attic space and exhaust hot, humid air at the highest part of the attic space. Improper placement of intake or exhaust vents reduces the amount of attic space that is exposed to this continuous airflow. For example, if exhaust is placed too low on the roof, or if exhaust is stacked, as shown in these roof louvers, it may function as an intake and disrupt or short-circuit the airflow through the entire attic space. The solution is to ensure that intake is placed at the lowest possible point of the roof, at or near the soffits, which typically aligns with the lowest part of the attic space. Likewise, exhaust should be placed at the highest possible point on the roof, at or near the ridge, which typically aligns with the highest part of the attic space. 2. Mixing exhaust products on the same attic space. Installing two or more different types of exhaust vents on the same attic space can short-circuit proper airflow. This means that some of the exhaust vents may act as intake vents and restrict airflow through the portion of the attic space below those exhaust vents. In addition, it may allow weather or debris infiltration. Sometimes, installing the wrong vent for the roof design can lead to mixing products. For example, a ridge vent installed on a hip roof with very little ridge line may not provide enough exhaust NFVA for the attic space. Oftentimes, another exhaust vent, such as a roof louver or power vent, is added to supplement the ridge vent, which can ultimately create issues. The solution is to install one type of exhaust vent on the attic space that can meet the exhaust NFVA requirements and allow the air to flow throughout the attic space. 3. Cutting the ridge vent opening too long. While a ridge vent may be installed across the entire ridge for aesthetics, that does not necessarily mean that the entire ridge air slot below the vent should be cut open. This may result in too much exhaust, which may cause the ventilation system to be out of balance. The opening of the ridge air slot should match the amount of exhaust NFVA required for a specific attic space. This attic space requires 288 square inches of exhaust. So if we're using a 4-foot plastic ridge vent with 18 square inches per lineal foot of NFVA, only 16 feet of the 40-foot ridge should be cut open. The solution is to open the ridge air slot according to the required exhaust NFVA for the attic space and always balance with the same amount of intake NFVA. 4. Clogged or blocked intake vents. While intake vents may have been installed correctly, they may become ineffective over time if they are clogged on the outside with paint, dirt, dust, or even spider webs. They may also become blocked on the inside if the attic insulation is installed over the vents. The solution is to keep the intake vents clean by removing any paint, dirt, or spider webs that may have accumulated over time. Insulation in the attic should also be kept away from the intake vents using attic baffles if necessary. Finally, it's also important to make sure that a hole has been properly cut in the soffits to allow air to enter the intake vents. 5. Missing or inadequate intake. It is understood that intake is often the most important part of an attic ventilation system. So when there is inadequate or no intake, an exhaust vent may not function properly. This is not only key on static exhaust vents like ridge vents or roof louvers, but inadequate intake may negatively affect powered exhaust vents as it is working too hard to pull air through the attic space. The solution is to make sure you always have a balanced attic ventilation system with the proper amount of intake and exhaust ventilation for the attic space being ventilated. For more information and help in calculating the amount of ventilation products needed for your attic, visit gaf.com/ventcalculator. GAF.